she's a super mum, a super model, and she's married to an Aussie superhero. And while starring in blockbusters like The Fast and the Furious, Elsa Pataky is used to an action-packed lifestyle. But it's Elsa's newest role in Interceptor that has her taking centre stage in the middle of the Pacific Ocean.
Interceptor, what is your status?
Seven terrorists seized our vessel, and they tried to take the command centre.
Get out of here alive.
Not going so well for you, is it? You plan for every possible outcome. But you couldn't plan for me.
And Elsa Pataky joins us now live. It is so great to see you.
Oh, hello.
Thank you for having me.
And it is so great to see you in this. You are amazing.
Thank you.
I've forgotten completely what your husband even does. This is extraordinary.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, it was a lot of work, I have to say. Yeah, and I knew it because I know how hard Chris works in these movies and how difficult it is and to get, you know, like a train and everything for them. So I knew, and I say to the director, I want 5 months, I need time to just train, and I really wanted to portray the strength of those US Army girls that, you know, they are like, they go through like a lot of that military training, they're strong, and like, and she has a few fights in the movie, which I wanted to do all by myself. I wanted to do them all, like, because I just wanted to enjoy it, because I've been like fan of action movies my whole life. I grew up watching Indiana Jones. I wanted to be that like female Indiana Jones.
So. Oh, I love that you say that. I love that. Can I just... You kick ass in this movie. You really do. I love that you do the fight scenes yourself as well. How was it training for the fight scenes? Because they're quite highly choreographed, right?
Yes, yes. You have to actually memorize, like, every move, like, every single move. Like, there was probably 800 moves that you have to memorize.
800?
Yes.
Wow.
Because there's, like, it's a choreography. It's like a dance, we'll say. Like, you have to know how it's your step. You don't, like, punch, then you just go down, then you just get the other hand. And if you miss one, you will just, like, you hit the other person, and the other person will hit you. So you really have to do it again and again. So every day it was like 4 hours training every morning to just go through every fight. And you go, like, you do piece by piece, but you have to have them all in your head. So then when you do them, it's like, okay, one gone, take it out of my brain, get to the other
wow.
one. You know? And it was fun. It was
so
really fun.
So who trained you?
So I had an amazing stunt team, and there was two women, which is great, because actually, like, my stunt coordinator, which is it's a woman, she says, like, actually our center of gravity is different than men, so we fight different. So she was just really conscious about that, and just like she made these fights for a woman, and like, she have to be quicker, smarter, you know, agile. And like, be ahead of their opponent, you know, because they are big guys, but she's fighting against them. But to be believable that she can actually win that fight, you know.
So you could take Thor down now, right?
Yeah, I think so. I'm totally pretty confident now.
Did it have a long fight. Did it take a bit of convincing to let them do your own fight scenes and your own stunts?
Well, yes, in a way, they're always a little bit, like, scared in a way.
Insurance. Hello, yeah.
But, you know, this movie was, like, it doesn't have a huge budget, like, in a way, so we couldn't do CGI that much. So they were really happy for me to just try everything.
I was the, like, real deal.
Exactly. I want to do it. I want to be involved. Even the scene with the arms, I did that one too. So I just wanted to enjoy it, yeah.
And we should mention it's a cracker of a story as well, because, of course, it's written by Matthew Riley, who, you know, is an Australian author who's just sold gazillions of books. Yeah. And he also directed.
He also directed. It's his first time directing a movie, and I was really impressed with him. He was so prepared. Like, I couldn't believe it. He would come every day with his, like, old drawing for every scene, like, we were doing. Every shot of the movie, he will have it drawing himself.
Wow.
Nobody does that. So, and he just knew, like, how to create an amazing environment, positive, you know, because he had, like, he was really excited to be part of this project.
You said as a little girl that you watched Indiana Jones and dreamed of one day being a female Indiana Jones. To have some female action heroes is so great. You've got a little girl. What does it mean to you that perhaps you are setting that benchmark, if you like, setting that example?
Exactly. That's one of the things I wanted, because she's like, my kids, she sees me every day, like, you know, doing lunchbox, going, picking up the school. It was just mum. So for them to see, like, I can do, like, being Chris is the man, like, action man in the house, they were like, Mom, can you do this? Really? So that was really exciting for them, especially for my daughter, as you said, because it just makes her think like, oh, I can do it. I can do it too, you know? I'm like, you don't need to be a man to do these things in a way, you know? So it's very inspirational for them, for my boys too, that a woman, you know, can fight, same as a, like as a man. So it was really like something that I really wanted to do for them to be like, oh, can Dad can do it, but Mum can do it too.
And it's I love that. And look, obviously it's got fabulous action in this movie, but it also tells really important stories as well, doesn't it, about women in the military?
Yeah. And like one of the things that got me really interesting about the role is when Matt said, I want the lead to be a woman that is a mature woman that had a life, because exactly like what had happened to her made her be... like we saw her after, like with that attitude that like, yeah, they took me down. I had a, like a horrible like experience that she has. Like we know like she's like sexual assault in like in her like time before, and they took her down. So for her to this time being in that situation, say, I'm not gonna give up this time. I'm just gonna do it, you know? So that story behind, it just gives like a depth into the character that was really important for me to tell. And I was excited to see like, oh yeah, it's a woman that had a life and now she is where she is because what happened to her, to you past. Know? Yeah.
Well, get a sense of her past.
Yes,
you're
exactly.
in demand, Elsa, if we can say. You've also just finished filming Poker Face, which Russell Crowe and Liam Hemsworth, who I gather you've probably met a couple of times. What can you tell us about that? I know a lot of it's hush-hush.
Yeah, no, it was great. Like having like been working, he's been my like actor, like hero, like since I was little, like you know. So having the opportunity to work with him and like to have him directing me, Liam is part of, so he's in the family. So we had a great time. He was like, we laughed, we had a good time, and you know, it was just like it's exciting to shoot again in Australia.
Yes,
and with Russell, you know, it was just like it's a good movie. It was another, and it's a character that's completely different movie that done in this movie. So it's just like that's like I would like the thing of our profession that you can do so different things.
Versatile
in different. It's still a strong, independent woman too, which is great. I have like something about those kind of characters.
Oh,
I
wow! And you played them so well. Hey, with Interceptor, you worked with your husband Chris Hemsworth. He was executive producer. How did that go?
No, good. I mean, from the beginning, he wanted me to do this movie. He said, you're going to, like, love this movie, and he wanted to support me. And he knows he's a professional in this kind of movie, so he was thinking that the most important thing is having a great team around you and that stunt team to do all the actions, of the action scenes. And he took also Sam Hargrave to be an action consultant, which is his director in Extraction, so... He really wanted me to have a good time and enjoy. And of course, he had a little bit of tips of how to fight.
I bet he did. Yeah. Just a few.
Just to take them or leave them now, I reckon.
I know what I'm doing now.
You're brilliant. You can see Elsa in Interceptor at select cinemas from tomorrow, or it's streaming on Netflix from June 3rd. Exciting, you can catch it on the big screen and then go watch it again at home.
That's right.
Elsa, thanks for coming in and congrats on the movie.
Thank you for having me.
Well done.
Great.
Just amazing.